Hello everybody, today we are here again with Nir Ehrlich about how to manage the cash flow in your dropshipping business and what is the cash flow. We decided to create this video after the very, very, very successful video which we released a few days ago about the PayPal reports and how to work with them and why we need them. So today Nir will show you the next step in the finance management for our dropshipping businesses. Enjoy. Hey Nir.
Hi guys, thanks Leo. So as Leo said, hi, my name is Nir from MyProfit, and today I want to talk to you and discuss about positive flow of cash. I call this subject flow of cash because it divided to two directions, positive flow and negative flow. And today I want to focus on the positive flow. The positive flow of cash means every transaction that come into your business. That means all the amount of all the money that defines your monthly revenue. So basically there are three sources of positive flow of cash, and I want to talk to you guys about them. The first one is PayPal, all the payments from the customers. The second one is PayPal again. That's all the positive fees in case of a refund to your customer. We talked about it in the previous video. I will show you the numbers again. And the third one is the credit card or any other way that you pay your suppliers, because in cases of refunds, your suppliers pays you back. And the best way you can see it is in your credit card, in your credit card monthly files. So first, I want to open together again the PayPal report and drill down to the data, and I will show you the most important numbers that we should see together. So just let me share my screen. So I want to show you again the two important numbers that we talked about it in the previous video. If you remember, I put it in a green remark, the amount received. Please, I want you to take this notice and to write down the numbers so you can understand the example perfectly. So the first number is in the amount received. We've got from our customers 1,560 euro. This is the amount received. The second one from PayPal is in column G, refunded fees. This is the refunded fees that PayPal gave us back in cases of refund. And the amount is 50 euro. So this is the two numbers that you should write down and remember. So now I want to take you to the third source. Third source is a credit card, and I want to show you how you can sort the data. Just let me share my screen and I will drill down to the numbers. Okay, so there are all kinds of credit card download Excel. I will show you mine. The differences are minor. So there are five columns. We see here the date. We see in column C the name of suppliers, the name of business that you paid money for, and the amount of money. So you have to remember that there are two kinds of sellers. There are two options. Maybe you just use your card only for to buy from suppliers like Amazon, like AliExpress. And there are options, of course, that you use the credit card personally. This is why there is a potential of a big noise in this credit card, and we have to know how to sort the data a perfect way. So first, we're going to take the first row and to filter it. You go to the Excel file. You touch, you click the data and filter it. Why I do it, I will explain it to you. I want to find all the negative number. Why is that? Because the negative number represents all the money that your supplier gave you back. So I will go to the filter. I will click number filter less than zero. I click enter, and then I see all the red numbers are negative numbers. This is the first step. You can see these are all negative numbers. The first step, I will go to column C, and I will sort it by A to Z. The reason that I'm doing it, because I want to gather together all the name of businesses, because I want to look for something suspicious. It's not my supplier. In this case, I work only with Amazon and with AliExpress, and when I drill down the numbers, I see suspicious line here. This is not, this is my name. This is a personal payment that I pay. So it's not Amazon. It's not AliExpress. I will delete it right away. That's it. Now I will look for another suspicious row. I see none. So everything is clear. Everything is good. So the only thing that is left is to take all the numbers and to calculate it together to make a sum. I will sum all together and I see it is 594 euro. I will write it down, 594 euro, and that's it. I will mark it in a green color, and that's it. Now we have three numbers and we can calculate it together. It's 594, and we go back to the PayPal. It's two numbers. It's 1,560 from the PayPal amount received, and the 15 euro from the fees. And the, after we add it together, the result is 2,169 euro. So basically, this is the only way to calculate the revenue. This is your real revenue of the store of your business. So basically, that's it, Leo. This is the summary of the flow cash of in a positive way. This is how I do it every month. I don't know another way to do it. And that's it.
Great. I think that we can also do another video later about how to organize all this together in like Excel file or something like this. So I think it will be like a series of videos. Okay. Great. Thank you very much, Nir. I will put a link to your system here under the video of MyProfit, so people can also check the description and see your system. And there we will also attach a blog post when we will create about this topic. So see you on the next videos. Thank you very much for being here today, Nir. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Leo. Thank you, guys. Bye-bye.